Auric Broods, Morgok's Krushas stomp their way into the Beastgrave, smashing their enemies and racking up the glory points and war counters with ease. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint Morgok's Krushas, using tips and techniques to get them on the table in no time at all and looking great. So grab your paints and brushes and let's get started. So in this video, we're going to show you how to paint Morgok himself, but the tips and colours we're going to use here are transferable to the other models in the warband too. So once you've watched this video, you'll be able to paint Ardskull and Thug as well. Now, to prepare our model for painting, we've already undercoated him here with Xandri Dust Spray. It's a nice neutral colour which is perfect for the paint job we're going to be giving him. Let's start painting then, and the first paste coat we're going to apply is Deathworld Forest, which we're going to put all over Morgok's skin. We're painting the skin first as it's the deepest part of the miniature. Grab your medium layer brush and let's get started. Let's grab some Deathworld Forest from the pot like so, and onto our palette. Now when we're adding base coats onto our miniature, we're going to add a little bit of water from our pot here, mix it onto our palette in the paint here, just to thin that paint down. That will help that paint go on a little smoother. Then, onto our miniature. Here, we're applying Deathworld Forest all over Morgok's skin. You'll see over the Xandri dust, it goes on nice and evenly in one coat. So just apply a nice even coat all over the skin of the Auric. Take your time and be as neat as you possibly can, but don't worry if you do make a mistake and hit other parts of the model that aren't flesh. You can always go back later on and correct those mistakes. There we go, that's our first base coat applied and we're off to a flying start. Right, let's finish that flesh off next, and we'll start with a wash of Athonian camo shade all over the skin. Then once that's dry, we'll apply layers of Deathworld Forest and Elysian Green, before highlighting the flesh with Ogryn camo and Krieg khaki. First of all, that wash of Athonian camo shade. For this, we're going to our medium shade brush. Let's take some paint from the pot and add it to our palette here. Now we're going to be adding a little bit of water here to thin this down, just a touch, not too much. There we go, just a little bit of water there. A nice thinner wash there to make it go on a bit smoother. Then onto the model. Here, we're applying this Athonian camo shade wash all over the flesh. Just like so. You want a nice even coat all over. Don't allow it to gather in the recesses and pull. Just be using your brush there to make sure you're moving it around. Perfect. Apply this all over the flesh. Allow about 10 minutes for it to fully dry. Once it has, move on to the next stage. Once that's dry, we've gone back to our pot of Deathworld Forest, and here with a medium layer brush, we're just going to be layering on top of the muscles like so. Crucially here, we're leaving the previous colour in the recesses. So we're just trying to pick out the higher areas, such as the muscles like this. Do this around the entire model, and once that's done, we'll move on to the next stage. Next up, we've thinned down some Elysian green with a touch of water, and now we're going to apply as a layer again onto the flesh. So here we're just applying onto the raised areas again, leaving some of that Deathworld Forest we've just painted showing through to get a nice cool transition between the greens. Next up, grab your small layer brush, and we've really thinned down some Ogryn camo, and we're going to just apply onto the raised areas of the skin. So picking out the ridges and such all over the model like this, and the edges of the muscles too. Take your time with this stage, be as neat as you possibly can. Next up, we've taken the tiniest amount of Krieg khaki on a small layer brush. I'm just going to pick out the highest ridges on the face. There we go, that's the highlighting on the flesh done. There's just one last thing we're going to do on the flesh here, and that's to add a red glaze to the lips and ears of our Auric to give a little bit of warmth to the skin. For this, we're using Caribou Crimson. We're going to thin it down with a bit of water. Let's grab a medium layer brush for this. Again, take some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. Now here, we're going to be adding quite a bit of water to thin it right down, so it's almost the consistency of water itself with a touch of red in it. There we go. Perfect. Then we'll load the brush up and onto the miniature. Here, we're going to be just painting along the edges of the lips here, just the bottom lip as well, like so. This will help define the lip and also give the skin a little bit of warmth. We're going to do the same on the inside of his ears as well. So just here and the other side too. And there we go. With that, the flesh is complete. All right, up next, let's tackle that yellow armor that Morgok wears. Now, because we undercoated our model here with Xandri Dust, we can actually go straight to a layer paint to use as a base coat. Now, this is unusual, but this is the right way to do this colour. We'll start off by base coating the armour with Uriel Yellow. Grab your medium layer brush for this. Now we're going to take some paint from the pot here and onto our palette like so. We're going to add quite a bit of water here to thin it down. We want this to go on nice and thinly. So then, onto the miniature. Here, we're going to be painting onto Morgok's armour all over the yellow bits. So just paint it on very carefully like so. Don't worry too much if you go onto other armour areas at the moment, but do try as hard as you can not to hit the skin. Now as this goes on, you'll see it's going on quite thinly, so you may need a couple of coats to get a nice solid colour, but it's absolutely normal. Just apply a second coat once the first one's dried. If you're worried about which parts of the model are meant to be yellow and which are meant to be black, have a good look at the box art on the back of your box. There we go, that's the yellow armour base coated. Up next, let's shade into the recesses of the armour to help break up that yellow shape. Here we're going to make our own shade using Doomball Brown mixed with Lamian Medium. Here's how we're going to do it. First of all, we're going to take some Lamian Medium out of our pot like so. We're looking for about 6 or 7 brushfuls. 4, 5, 6. There we go. Maybe one more, 7. Then we'll wash our brush off to make sure there's no medium left on there at all. And we'll get one brushful of Doomball Brown like so and mix it in like that. What that'll do is give us a really, really weakened Doomball Brown, almost to the point of it being a glaze. Then we'll load our brush up here. We're using a small layer brush here. And then onto the miniature. Here, we're going to very carefully place this into the recesses all over the yellow armour. Just carefully dropping it into the gaps in between the armour, like so. Now, it doesn't matter too much if you make a mistake here. You can always go back and correct it later on using Uriel Yellow again. But work your way around the armour like so, dropping this Doomball Brown mix into all the recesses around the armour. There we go, that's the shading applied all over the armour. Alright, up next let's highlight the armour. And for this we'll do two highlights. First of all, Flash gets yellow, and then finally a highlight of Dawn Yellow. For both of these we're going to be using our small layer brush. Let's start with Flash gets yellow and take some paint from the pot like so, and onto the palette. Now here, we want to make sure our paint goes on nice and thin. So adding a little bit of water here, just a touch. I'm also going to make sure we've got a nice pointy brush. So I'm going to rifle our brush back to make sure it's nice and thin. Bingo. Then, onto the model. Here, we're carefully applying Flash Gets Yellow highlights onto the vertices of all of the armour plates. So very carefully, we're just painting those lines on like so, all over the model. Now this will take some time, but it's really worth taking the time to get it nice and neat as possible, to get nice sharp highlights as best you can. With that done, we'll apply a second highlight, this time Dawn Yellow, going inside the highlight we've just done. So very, very, very fine lines going down the vertices of the yellow armour, like this. And there we go, with that highlight down, the yellow armour is done. Up next, let's paint the black armour sections on Morgok. For this, we'll start with a base coat of Abaddon Black. Then we'll highlight up with Dark Reaper, Thunderhawk Blue, and Fenrisian Grey, respectively. First of all, that base coat of Abaddon Black. For this, we're using our medium layer brush. Again, let's grab some paint from the pot and onto the palette. Just a touch of water here, not too much though. There we go, perfect. Then onto our miniature. Here, we'll be painting the armour sections that are black all over here, a nice even coat. Now be super careful here, not to hit the yellow or the skin, but don't worry if you do, you can go back in to correct it if you need to. Also, while this paint is out, we'll be painting the loincloth here as well, and his trousers at the back as well. If you're a bit confused as to which parts of Morgok's armour are black, have a good look at the box art and that will help you out. Once that's base coated, we're highlighting the black armour sections, first with Dark Reaper. Here we thinned it down quite a bit and we're applying quite a thick highlight, just very carefully around the very edges and vertices of the armour panels. Up next, grab some Thunderhawk Blue and apply very fine highlights to the edges of the black armour panels. And the last highlight on the armour is Fenrisian Grey. We've thinned this down with just a touch of water and applying it to the very, very edges of the armour panels. There we go, that's the black armour panels done. Let's look next at painting the black cloth, as we're going to paint this in a different way. This is the loincloth and also Morgok's trousers too. Now we've already base coated them with Abaddon Black. I'm going to start by adding a couple of layers, first of Corvus Black, then Eshing Grey. Then we'll highlight that with Dawnstone and then Carrickstone. For this we're grabbing our medium layer brush. Let's grab some Corvus Black from the pot like so, and onto our palette here. Again, just a touch of water, just to thin it down. Perfect. Then, onto the model. Here, we're going to be applying Corvus Black as a layer, leaving the deepest recesses the original colour. That's a Abaddon Black underneath. This colour will be very subtle when it goes on, but that's absolutely perfect. We want a nice subtle transition between the colours. Next up, we've thinned down some Eschen Grey, and here we're applying it as a layer on the black cloth areas. So again, just layering it up, leaving the recesses the original colour. So we get a nice layer effect going towards the higher areas of the cloth. On the trousers at the back, we're doing the same again. Just layering up, leaving the darker areas in the recesses, like so. Next up, grab some Dawnstone and a small layer brush. Thin it down a touch, and we're going to add it to the very edges as a highlight on the cloth. Finally, to the cloth, we're adding a highlight of Carrick Stone. Again, very fine highlight, just inside the highlights we've already applied. There we go, that's the black cloth done. All right, up next, let's tackle the metal areas of the miniature. Now here we're going to start off with a base coat of Iron Warriors. Then we'll add a layer of Lead Belcher to some areas. Over the top of that, a cheeky shade of Fugan Orange in the recesses to make it look like rust. Then we'll highlight with Iron Hand Steel and Stormhost Silver respectively. First of all, that base coat of Iron Warriors, and for this we're using our medium layer brush. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette like so. Now here we're going to add just a tiny amount of water, but not too much for metallic paint. Just a little bit, there we go, it's perfect. Then onto Morgok. Here we're painting all of the metal areas. So we're going to be looking at the big boss choppers here. Any other metal parts in the miniature, such as his earrings, other metal bits too. Don't forget the hilts of the choppers too. And also on the back, we've got a little bit of chainmail here as well to paint that in down too. Next up, Lead Belcher. And here we're painting it just onto the front of the blades on the boss chopper. You can see there's a natural line that goes around the front there. Painting up to that line like so, around the front of the blades like this. Do this on both boss choppers, both front and back, and move on to the next stage. Next up, we're going to drop some Fugan Orange into some of the recesses around the metal areas to give a hint of rust. Next up, we're painting Iron Hand Steel as a highlight onto all the metal areas. It's very carefully just picking out the very edges like so. When you get to the front of the boss choppers here, as well as highlighting the very edge of the chopper, add a couple of flicks back as well into the blade like so, just to add a couple of marks where he's hit someone on the head with his big chopper. Last but not least, we're applying a very fine highlight of Stormhost Silver to the very edges of all the metal areas. There we go, with that, the metal areas are done. All right, up next, let's have a look at the strapping on Morgok. That's the strapping around his arms and legs, and also just below his topknot too. We'll start off with a base coat of Rakarth Flesh. Then we'll wash those areas with Agrax Earthshade, before highlighting up with Carrick Stone and a Shapti Bone. First of all, for that Rakarth Flesh, we're going to use our medium layer brush. Again, let's take some paint from the pot. And as always with a base coat, just a tiny touch of water, but not too much. There we go. Then, onto Morgok himself. Here we're picking out the strapping areas. So we're going to start off up here at the top knot. Just there, just the strapping there. We're also going to pick out all the strapping around his arms and legs as well. So that's this bit here. We're not going to be picking out the strapping on the weapon. We'll be doing that later on with something different. Next up, add a wash of Agrax Earthshade over those areas, here using a medium layer brush for added control. Once the wash is dry, we're going back in with Carrick Stone and a small layer brush and adding highlights all over the straps like so. So very carefully bringing your highlights round on the very edges of the straps. Take your time on this one, be as neat as you possibly can. Finally, we're adding a highlight of a Shapti Bone around the very tips of the straps here. So just very carefully around the tips like so. And there we go, that's the strapping done. Let's move on to the red areas of Morgok next. That's his mighty topknot and also the straps on his weapons too. We'll start off with a base coat of Corn Red. Then over the top of that, we'll wash it with Agrax Earthshade. Then we'll start highlighting up, first again with Corn Red, then Wazdaka Red, and then Squig Orange. For that base coat of Corn Red, we're using our medium layer brush. Again, grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. The tiniest touch of water to help thin that paint down. Then onto our miniature. Here we're painting the red areas, so we're looking at this top knot here on his head. Be super careful here not to hit the strapping as you get nearer to it. Also, we're looking at painting the weapon straps too. So this is the straps on his big boss choppers here. Once that's dry, add a layer of Agrax Earthshade over the top, just washing it all over the red, like this. Next up, we're back in with the corn red again, this time highlighting the individual hairs on the top knot. So just take your time bringing it round, make sure you're being as neat as you possibly can on those hairs. We're also going to go back in on the weapon straps too, just making sure we're leaving the recesses the original colour, just layering over the top like so. With that done, let's add some Wazdaka red to the top knot. Now here we're using the side of the brush to pick out individual hairs, and we're concentrating towards the end here, which means this end here will end up being darker, and this end here will end up being lighter. We're also going to highlight the weapon straps too. Here we're just using the very tip of the brush to just pick out the very edges of the straps. Finally, on the red, we're doing the same again, this time with Squig Orange. Here we're going to be using the edge of the brush to highlight the very, very tip of the top knot, and the hairs just like this. Then on the straps, we're also going to be highlighting the very edges of them too. There we go, that's the red done. All right, up next, let's paint the skulls, teeth and claws. We're going to do these all the same way, and we'll start off with a base coat of Steel Legion Drab. Then we'll highlight with Carrack Stone, and finally a highlight of a Shabty Bone. First of all, grab your small airbrush and your Steel Legion Drab. Let's take some paint from the pot like so, and onto our palette. Now here we're dealing with really small details on the model, so we're going to add quite a bit of water here, just to thin it down a bit. We're just going to make sure we've got a nice point on the brush too. Bingo. Then, onto the model. Here we're picking out the various bits of bone on the model. So we've got Morgok's teeth actually in his jaws here. We've got this skull up here. Various teeth and things hanging around his waist and around his shoulder pads, and also his claws as well. Next up, we're highlighting these areas with Carrack Stone. Now when it comes to painting teeth like this, we're dragging the paintbrush back from the point of the tooth towards the base, leaving part of the base still Steel Legion Drab, like this. And last but not least, a Shabty Bone is used to highlight all of those areas we've painted bone. There we go, that's the bone, teeth and skulls on our model done. Let's paint the remaining leatherwork next, such as his belt and other bits of straps on the model too. We'll start off with a base coat of Rhinox Hide, then we'll move on to Mournfang Brown to highlight, and then XV88 to highlight after that. First of all, the Rhinox Hide. Now, these details are really small, so we're using our small airbrush. Let's grab some paint from the pot again and onto our palette like so. Cheeky touch of water here to thin it down. Perfect. Onto our model. Now here we're picking out the remaining parts of strapping and leatherwork here, such as the strap holding the tooth onto his belt here. There's also strapping up here on the skull where it attaches it to the top knot, so we'll do that too. And don't forget to paint his belt at the same time. You can see his belt underneath there. Paint that with the Rhinox Hide too. Next up, we're highlighting those areas with a touch of Mournfang Brown, again using our small layer brush. Last up here, one final highlight of XV88 on those leather areas. There we go, that's the leather work done. Now let's move on to those severed heads hanging around Morgok's waist. And for this, we'll start off with a base coat of Rakarth Flesh. We'll wash over those faces with Agrax Earthshade and then add Druchy Violet onto the flesh to add a little bit of bruising around the eyes. Then we'll highlight back up with Rakarth Flesh and finally Pallid Witch Flesh. First of all, the base coat of Rakarth Flesh. Grab your medium layer brush for this. Get some paint from the pot, add onto our palette like so. Again, a touch of water here just to thin it down so it goes on real smooth. Bingo. Then onto our miniature. Here we're just picking out both of the heads around the waist and being super careful not to hit anything else, like the cloth or the yellow armour. So take your time here, be as neat as you possibly can. Next up, we've thinned down some Agrax Earthshade with a touch of water. Now we're applying it all over the faces of our severed heads. Next up, grab some Druchy Violet, which we're going to thin down with a touch of water. I'm going to just put it around the eyes here to make them look bruised and dead. Over the top of this, we're going to add a layer of Rakarth Flesh again, just picking out the higher points on the faces. Then last on the faces, we're adding a highlight of pallid witch flesh, which we slightly thin down with a touch of water to make it really subtle. There we go, that's those dead heads painted. But those heads are held onto Morgok's waist by some hair, so let's paint that now. We'll paint the hair coming off the end of his boss chopper too. We'll start with a base coat of Rhinox hide, and we'll highlight that up with Steel Legion Drab, followed by Carrick Stone. First of all, that base coat of Rhinox hide. For this, we're using our medium layer brush again. Again, grab some paint from the pot, add a touch of water to thin it down, and then we go onto the miniature. So here we're picking out the hair that's coming off the side of these dead heads. So we've got a little bit coming off here on the side, like little mutton chops here. We've also got the hair that comes off at the top over here, and the hair holding him to his belt as well. Also, we're going to paint this little trophy hair coming off the side of the boss chopper here as well. Next up, we're picking out those hairs with Steel Legion Drab, just layering on top very carefully with a small layer brush. When painting the hair on the trophy coming out the bottom of his chopper, again, we use the side of the brush as we did on the top knot and just work it very carefully back, leaving the hair nearest to the chopper the darker colour. Then we're adding a highlight of Carrick Stone on the very end of all of the hair. Just a tiny little touch like this, just to highlight it up. On the trophy hair here on the chopper, just highlight the very tips furthest away from the chopper. There we go, that's the hair done. All right, time for some nerve-wracking detail. Now it's going to move on to Morgok's eyes. For this, we're going to be using our smallest layer brush and a touch of corn red. Here's how we're going to do it. First of all, take your small layer brush with a nice point on it and just get a little bit of dot of corn red coming from the pot like so. Just a tiny amount like that. We're not going to put it onto the palette or use water here. Just a tiny dot. Perfect. Then, onto the miniature. Here, brace yourself against your painting handle like so. And with this dot of corn red, just very carefully touch where the eyes are on the miniature. Hold your breath. There we go, that's Morgok himself, just about done. But we're going to add an optional extra here. We're going to add some blood and gore onto the miniature using Blood for the Blood God. Grab your medium layer brush and let's do this. Let's take some paint from the pot here and onto our palette. Now, Blood for the Blood God's quite thick, and we're not going to thin it down here because we don't want it to be thinned. But we are going to make sure we're not overloading our brush with too much paint. Then, onto the model, what we're going to do is add it onto areas we want it to be nice and gory. So under here, where we've got these heads where they've been severed, we're going to add some Blood for the Blood God under there. You don't have to be too neat with this, it's blood after all. We're actually going to have a little bit of blood trickling down the leg as well, where it's gone bleeding down the armour. Also, over here, on the big boss chopper, we're going to add a touch of blood here as well, where he's bonked someone on the head with his big chopper, just like this. There we go, the blood's been applied onto the model and you can see it looks disgusting. All right, the last thing we're going to be doing on the model is painting the base. Now for this, we're going to start off by applying a base coat of Skaven Blight Dinge over the entire base. For this, grab your medium base brush. Let's grab some paint from the pot like so and onto our palette here. We're going to add a touch of water here to help thin it down, make it go over the base a little easier. There we go, then onto the model. Here, we're just applying this all over the entire base. So the ground, the skulls, the rocks, literally everything. You may find it's quite thin as it gets applied, so you might want a second coat for a nice solid colour. Okay, that's a nice solid colour on the base. Let's start by painting the rocky ground first of all. Here we're going to be dry brushing. We'll start with a dry brush of Rakarth flesh, then a dry brush of Deepkin flesh over the top of that. For both of these, we're using our small dry brush. Let's take some paint from the pot, and here we're going to add it to our tissue paper and brush off most of the paint onto the paper like so. That's why it's called dry brushing, as you don't want very much paint left on the brush. Perfect. Then, onto the model. Here we're going to very carefully dry brush it all over the rocky ground, like so. Try and avoid the big rocks if you can, but don't worry if you do hit them. We're going to go back later on and paint those in a bit. But this rocky ground at the bottom here, getting painted like this. Over the top of this, a dry brush of Deepkin flesh. A little bit lighter this time. Once we've done this, we're going to go back and repaint those rocks with Skaven Blight Dinge, where we've accidentally hit it with a dry brush. There we go, that's the rocky ground done. All right, let's paint those big old rocks he stood on next, and for this we'll start with a dry brush of Dawnstone. Then we'll dry brush Administratum Grey over the top of that. For both of these, again, we're using our small dry brush. Let's take some Dawnstone from the pot here, and onto our bit of tissue paper here. We're just going to make sure most of the paint's gone. Again, we've got a nice dry brush. Perfect. Then, onto the miniature. Here, we're dry brushing the rocks that he stood on. So just nice circular motions. I'm just picking out those rocks as well. Don't worry about hitting the skull. We'll paint that in a second. When it comes to painting the rocks that is next to his feet like this, just linear motions like this along to make sure you're not actually hitting the feet with grey paint as well. Here, another dry brush of administratum grey, this time a little bit lighter over the top, so just picking out the very edges of the rocks. There we go, that's the rocks done. Let's pick out that skull and those teeth on the base next, and here we're going to paint them the same way we did skulls and teeth earlier. We'll start with a base coat of Steel Legion drab, and then add a layer of Carrick stone over the top of it. But when it comes to using a shabty bone, we'll dry brush the skull and the entire base at the same time to help bring that base together. First of all, that base coat of Steel Legion drab. Grab your medium layer brush for this. Take some paint from the pot like so, and onto the palette. Again, a touch of water here to help thin it down so it goes on real smooth. Then onto the miniature. Here we're going to be picking out the skulls and the bones and the teeth on the base. There's quite a few, so make sure you pick them all out. Have a good look as you're going around to make sure you've got them all. Next up, add a layer of Carrick stone over the top. Here using a small layer brush, so making sure we're leaving all the smaller areas of the recesses the original colour. Then finally, a light dry brush of a shabty bone over the entire base helps bring those colours together and unify the base. Once we've done this, we'll paint the rim of the base with a Baden black. And there we go, that's Morgok finished, ready to lead his crushers into battle. Remember, you can use these same techniques to paint both Art Skull and Thug too. So there's a couple of things to remember here. First of all, when you're applying that Uriel yellow base coat, it might take a few layers to build up a nice solid colour. You might be tempted to just slap one thick coat on to get it done quickly, but don't. Use as many thin coats as it needs to get a nice smooth base coat. Also, when applying all of your paints, try and be as neat as you possibly can, but don't worry if you make a mistake, everybody does. You can always go back later on and correct it. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting.